Well, I'd say it's about time we marry these two pieces together. You can see I've already been working on my rear lights a little bit. Now we gotta put it in and down, and you'll notice right here there's a little catch tab right there, and on the other side there is as well. So it'll actually slide down and hook into it once you get it in there. Now I do have to say I've tried this once before and I feel like it's easier to put one side in and get it to where you can manage it before you put the other side in. Because on the bed, it has just a tab that hooks right here. Let me see. Let me zoom out a little bit. That was in, fingers. You know what I mean? Just get you better view of seeing right there. It's missing out on the other side of the bed. Itself. It's a full hole. So then we line up the actual bed itself. Make sure our little stuff is at least able to go in, and then we'll add our little pieces over here, which are these. Really nifty. 06, 04, right and left. That's what happens when you paint stuff sometimes. There we go. Now each one's got its own curve. So make sure you put on the right one. And then it calls for the 2.3x5. To go right in there. Bingo. Heard that click into place, didn't you? Doing this hard body has definitely been a different experience. I think second one I've done, but this is definitely different. This is Team Raffy, and this is KillerBody, and As much as I do like this one, I think the next time I will again go with the KillerBody. It's been a much more enjoyable build. And the fitment of it is a lot better. The cracks indoors, that one, there's some issues on that one. Just didn't quite fit right. Just doing the other side. Try and put the screw in the hole. Don't say bad. See, now that's the hard body insulation right there. This is where we revert back to the actual instructions for the truck. So that's done. That part is done. Now, there you did the fender flares, but now we're going to put in the automatic, the body step, the actual body clip part that holds it to the chassis. Bag number 7. Like, seriously, since I used scale bolts, I have one bag left, and that's the fender bolts. So, it's having me take these and these 2.5x6s right here. Sorry. And put them in through here. in here, and this is what's going to actually kind of lock it down onto the chassis. Make that nice and tight. Make sure you're doing it the right direction. There's a little lip and the screw sits going in that way. And then your taper will be on the back side. Then it takes 3x12 self tappers, and that's what gets attached to both points here and here. And then both these screws are gonna have to come out in order for me to put the other screws in. Hot up here today. Okay, now take it. And get these big long ones started. And then it says to use 2.3x6. To put back in there. Again, so we'll use some new ones this time. I know, intense moment right there, wasn't it? And that screw in there. That's that on the front. I've already done the front fenders. So let's move on. Now this is where we attach the rear fenders. And also, we'll pull the chassis back over here real quick if you want to put that. Back body mount on it. And it slides in there. Just like so. Now, what screws am I supposed to use to put it in there? Or is that so I can take the body completely off anyway? Okay, so it gets mounted to the body first and then I can put the set screws into if I want to. Okay, very cool. That wants us to put it in these front, see, these front four holes right here. So let's do it. Coming up on 20 minutes. Ain't been bad. Well, that's in. That's in. So other than the wire sticking out, let's take him up a little bit and see if we can't stick his body on here. And get the first look at the body and the chassis together. Bumper sitting right here. Might have to move this bumper forward a little bit. I'll remove this lower bumper right here. Which I don't really want to do. So, well, that part's good. I'm going to move this bumper and see. I'm going to take it off and go from there. But for now, let's mat out. I'll let you know what happens, guys.